What's that doing?
Victory Sunday, amen. Does everybody have the victory?
Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes victory isn't a feeling, isn't it?
Amen.
It's faith. It's something that you have to accept by faith that you're going to be victorious in spite of how you feel.
Amen.
And I got up this morning, and I tell you what, I don't always feel it, but I know it.
Amen.
Amen. I know that I am victorious no matter what life throws my way. And you are too. Turn to your neighbor and say, you are victorious this morning.
You are victorious.
Like the Carolina Panthers.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Take note.
Hallelujah. We got some announcements to make this morning, men's minister. We had a fun time this last Friday night, as the pastor said. Fun, food, and fellowship. Those two always seem to go together, food and fellowship. But we're free and fun, amen, when we get together as men. And we had some burgers. Thanks for Brother Tim, amen, picking some up for us. And we had some chicken. And we had to get back to that bird for Peter. Amen. You know what I mean. Hallelujah. So we had a great movie as well, The Christmas Candle. And, I'm looking forward to the next men's fellowship meeting. It gets better every time we get together. And looking forward to that as well. Be in prayer for our men in the church. Amen. I'm a firm believer. If we'll be what God wants us to be in our homes, then praise the Lord. We're the gatekeeper in the home, aren't we?
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Don't forget about Sunday morning pre-prayer service at 9:30. If you're able to be here for that. Wednesday night Bible study at 7 p.m. 6:45. If you can be here, come here early for fellowship. And we encourage everyone to join us in the time of learning and discussion. November the 15th, which is today, Victory Sunday. Hallelujah. How many knows that you are an overcomer by the words of your testimony?
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. We testify today, and you give forth a testimony in this service today. You're setting yourself up to be an overcomer. Amen. So thankful for that. Be in prayer for our prison outreach, November the 21st. And also, don't forget about our Denver, North Carolina Christmas Parade, Saturday, December the 15th. Fifth of one of Denver's biggest events of the year. And our church, we plan to be a part and shine for Jesus. He is the reason for the season, isn't he?
Amen.
Amen. And the candy cane tracks have come in, about 2,500 of them. Amen. So I tell you what, those that you don't hand out, the dentist will get plenty of business, I'm pretty sure, on these. We now need candy canes to staple to the tracks. We plan to hand out the candy canes during the parade along with the float. Please bring in many candy canes to go with the tracks and help staple to the tracks as well. Don't forget about our children's ministry. Are you glad that we have a children's ministry at the church?
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. That is important. Be in prayer for that as well. And thank God for our children learning the Word of God. That's important. But as far as I'm concerned, when you begin to pour the Word into a child, you're setting that child up for success in an early time in his life. And it'll go with them. They'll never depart from it, the Bible says. Amen. So when you invite people to church, tell them about our children's ministry, that we have a place in Sunday morning for the children to go and learn the Word of God. Amen. And that way they'll be encouraged to come and they can enjoy the service while their children is being ministered to as well. Praise the Lord. This time we're going to go to the Lord in prayer. But before we do, we're going to take a prayer request. Does anybody have any prayer requests this morning?
Prayer for my studies.
Yes. Praise the Lord. Anybody else? Just remember our service today. God's will be done in this service, and hearts and lives will be changed and transformed. Hallelujah. And pray for the praise and worship team and the pastor as well as they minister to us today. And pray for our hearts that they'll be open to the Word of God and open to God's presence as well. Just remember my mom, she hurt her leg, and she's not going to church this morning. She's going to stay off of it. So we just remember her this morning, that the Lord will touch her and minister to her. Well, amen. Any unspoken requests?
We prayed last week for my niece. The baby is breech. This week, the doctor's going to try to turn the baby, so we'll pray that that is successful. And my niece, thank God, she is going to have the natural birth because we believe it.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Okay, if you would, let us all stand and give to the Lord in prayer this morning. Can we do that? Amen. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this time. We thank you, Lord, for the opportunity to come into your presence. God, the request that has been given this morning, Lord, and those that have gone unspoken, God, you see every heart here. Everything is laid bare and open before you this morning. God, we just call forth your reign and your rule in every situation. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. God, we just bind sickness, Lord. We bind passiveness. We bind, Father God, anything that would hinder, God, Lord, these blessings and these answers to prayers coming into manifestation. And we just call it forth and we command it to manifest. God, and we praise you and we thank you, Lord, that your kingdom is coming. Thy kingdom is coming, Lord, and thy will be done in every situation. Give us the mind and the heart to surrender, God, to your good and perfect will in every area that we're praying about this morning. And God, we just thank you and we praise you and we glorify you for it. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. Can we just lift our hands this morning to the Lord and praise him, for he is here in this house this morning. Amen. Prepare your hearts as they come to worship.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Yeah. and then we got a victory song.
So we need some clappers. We need some foot stompers.
Thank you. Lord God, that you are here and that we can have victory in you, victory in Jesus. And we do not have to worry or fret or be stressed out, worn out, or medicined out, Lord God. We can be full of you, Lord God, and we just thank you. And Lord God, we look to you this very moment and this very day, and we just say, Lord God, may you be lifted up in our lives and in our homes and in our church and in every way and always, and we thank you. And Lord, I just pray that your sweet spirit would flow in this moment, would flow in this service.
Hallelujah.
Would flow
Hallelujah.
In our lives and through our lives.
Hallelujah.
And Lord, we just thank you. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. If you'd like to turn to the passage, Isaiah chapter 43, I'm just going to share for a few minutes. About a month or so ago, someone mentioned to me I should put in writing or about what's happened over the last year, especially with the cancer. And Alan, would you mind getting my lights for the next few minutes while we'll have the lights on? And so I've been thinking and put it in writing, and while I was putting it in writing, I dropped a couple of tears. Is it okay to drop a tear, Paul?
Sure.
As a guy, all right.
Real man would.
What's that, real man would? Is that what you said, Paul? Real
yes,
man?
Sir.
Yeah. All right, at the right time, right? Some guys are crying for no reason. They need to pull their bootstraps, right? But some men, all right, there. But listen, so I'm going to share what God spoke to me and as I was writing. And so listen to this. I mentioned this actually yesterday, but listen, as I woke up today, think of this thought. God gave me another day, a gift from Him. Listen, every breath we have, every day that God gives us is a gift. It's a precious gift. Even the very breath, even this very moment right now is a gift from God. In the last year, I've learned this to be true. And listen, I understand in a greater way to enjoy the simple things in life.
Hallelujah.
The simple things in life. Even spending time with my children, spending time with you all.
Hallelujah.
The last year of my life has been tough. And how many's had a tough year or a tough month or a tough time in their lives? It's not to fret or worry about, but sometimes we go through some tough times. This says about a year ago, and I still need water. We all need water, but with the throat. My father-in-law passed away unexpectedly. I had come home from a prison outreach, a holiday dinner, the one that we mentioned we're doing in a couple weeks. And it went well. It was a good time that night, and lives were touched. But 2 in the morning, my 3 brother-in-laws knocked at our door. Now, may I tell you, that's not a good sign when the 3 brothers-in-laws are at the door. Is that true?
Amen.
That's never a good sign. And the pillar of my wife's family, Hank, had passed away. And he was always the one with the answers and the plan for his family. He was the pillar, the patriarch. And he's one that stood strong, and through tough times, his wife stood with him as well, and his family. And there's my father-in-law, Hank. He came a few times to church here, and when he was visiting. So listen to this, and he was always the one with the answers and the plan. Even I was encouraged by his example that he was a leader in his community and church. But even more so with his family and his wife, Marilyn. He would say he loved his family, but his wife was first. Amen?
Amen.
Got it right.
Is that getting it right?
Amen.
Yes, it is.
Listen, I'm going to mention this when I think about that. Listen, I strive. I mentioned this, I think, a couple weeks ago. I want to go to work and be a success. I don't wake up Monday and say, well, I just want to do okay on the job today. I don't prepare a message or I don't prepare for each Sunday and every day's ministry, but I'm prepared thinking, oh, this is an okay message and an okay service. No, I'm praying that if there's one person, 100 people, whoever's here, that God's here and God's lives are changed. But even more so, I pray that my daughter's life's changed, my son's life is changed, and my wife.
Amen.
My wife's first. I have and am learning even more that I can give all I have on my job and ministry in other areas of life, and it may or may not produce what we consider success. Has anybody ever done that? Strive to have done your best, and in man's eyes, you still didn't succeed. Has anybody felt that or had that happen?
Amen.
But when I hear, but I remember the tree story. Don't worry, Alan. Keep watering, keep planting, keep sowing.
Amen, amen, amen.
Eventually, we're going to bear fruit. But when I hear the morning phone call from Melissa, we talk almost every morning for just a moment, for a few minutes. I think, and I'm hearing that my sweetie's voice, that it's much more, that's important, that's much more important. When I pick up my 8-month-old Caleb and 4-year-old daughter Caitlin, and I hear, Daddy, 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 that's important. Yes, I want to bear much fruit in my life. However, I've learned to love my family more, to cherish and take and enjoy every time with them. It has not been easy for Melissa and her family. However, I've seen her grow stronger and have greater heart of compassion. Ever since I've known Melissa, she's been a woman of compassion. I think being a cancer nurse takes being a person of compassion, or any nurse.
Amen.
But I've seen her since she started singing again. Many times songs have been picked, and I've seen her drop a tear.
Amen.
It was touching her heart. Because think about this. Ministry is not just, you know, song sung or a sermon preached.
No, it's not.
There has to be heart. There has to be, well, Jesus wept. There has to be truly care about what we're doing and in life and connecting. And I believe God has worked through both Paul and Tim, and with songs being picked and messages and just connecting at the right moment to touch many lives, but to touch Melissa's to get back a feeling. Because how many knows when we go through something, sometimes you can just feel numb. Mm-hmm. And sometimes you just get out of bed, put your pants on, your boots, and go to work, and you're not feeling a thing. How many know sometimes you can just, sometimes you got to still keep moving forward? So listen, it's between life, ministry, and the loss of a loved one. We would think that would be enough. However, at the beginning of the year, I was having a sore throat, and I was thinking it was just a cold or acid reflux. Even the doctor, listen, when I went to the funeral, I thought her family was going to kick me out of the house because I was snoring. I think it started back then. I'm not sure. And even the doctor initially thought the same. It was acid reflux, sore throat. Just told me to take over-the-counter stuff. But then it continued and got worse. And in March, I'm in the hospital, being the good daddy, being the good husband. But I was coughing, and then Melissa said, go home. She wasn't sleeping. And the sore throat had gotten worse, and the snoring had gotten louder. Who knows, maybe my neighbors could hear it. I don't know. It was pretty loud. And maybe you all didn't hear. Maybe Hannah heard it. Maybe Hannah, she was like, she thought it was a truck, a train going by. It was their neighbor snoring, all right? But listen to this. To my surprise, she sent me home, and then after a week and a half, listen, sometimes it's smart to listen to your wife. And I listened to Melissa, and she said, you need to go to the doctor. And I'm like, all right. She said, go to the doctor. So finally, I did, and I got to the doctor's office, and he looked and examined me, and he thought, uh-oh, go get a scan. And so on March 20th, I heard a word I didn't think I would hear, for me, cancer. And I'm not one to cry much, but I had a few tears drop. And even as I was writing this, I had a few tears drop. Yes, my faith is in God, and I know He's a God of miracles. And it was hard to understand, and still is hard to understand, how I would get cancer. I don't smoke. I'm faithful to my wife. I'm not a drinker. I was in good health. And see, with throat cancer, those were questions I kept having to ask or answer, both verbally and on paper, because 90-some-high percent, it falls in those categories. It was throat cancer, and most of those reasons were mentioned. I was at odds with those questions, but sometimes life happens. How many of us know sometimes life happens?
Amen.
We don't know why. We won't know why until we like to get to heaven when they ask. And listen, for that pastor, worship pastor, about 4 months ago that had his children die, saw him run through a red light and smacked into a T-bone and lost his children. Why? They weren't doing anything. Why is a question we can ask and they only know when we get to heaven. We can ask God. The real question, listen, we must ask is when we are at the why moment, do we turn to God and do we get better? Do we get better? Do we turn to God? When we are numb and have lost the drive to care as much or unable to because we have gone through so much, do we allow God to carry us? The footprint story, right? We know the footprint story.
Yes.
When we feel all alone and maybe do not even feel God, do we run away from God or to God? Pastor Dane, my in-law's pastor, told my mother-in-law, Marilyn, after Hank passed away, continue to worship.
Hallelujah.
Continue to worship. Many times Melissa and Marilyn just were together and had worship music playing. No words could be said. Many times at church, I could see Melissa during worship or even worship practice not able to continue as emotions in God's presence overtook her. When life hits us hard, turn to God and worship. Allow Him to carry us, and I understand that more now. Listen, sometimes we don't feel it. We hear that Book of Acts and what kind of costs are created. We want to feel that. I want to feel God. I want to feel the presence.
Amen.
But sometimes we don't, and we still must continue to put faith in God, continue to trust that He'll see us through and bring us through. Praise God. I listened to Melissa when she told me to go back to the doctor. The cancer was caught early. Amen. Is that praise God?
Amen.
The treatment was tough. That was tough for me. I was told I took chemo like a champion. I took that well. Let's be honest. I was up for nights, slept 3 or 4 hours some weeks with those steroid medicine. I was doing like chores like a champion. All right. I was able to actually get the whole list done, Paul. Is that pretty good? The honey list. Okay. That's you almost need medicine to get it all done. All right. But it was tough and I felt my mind was not all there. And sometimes when I preached or even would study, I felt fuzzy. And some of you are saying, well, I don't know if it was that, but it was. All right. Even now, my energy is not 100% or able to do the normal days I would do. I'm used to getting up at 6 or before 6 in the morning and staying up till midnight or after to do everything I need to do. I would give time for work, family, and study late at night, and the energy is slowly coming back. But I'm high bouncing back. Amen. I'm getting there. I'm high bouncing back. And if you remember, high bouncing back is what? Because you're better than you were before. Radiation is what really got me. Remember, I showed the old mask. I brought the mask back in for a day. Wearing that for 20 times. That I don't want to do that again. All right. And so I have to do what I got to do. The chemo, I got the Purple Heart Award because I was a champion. I don't think I got this for the radiation. It was a little tougher. I didn't get the Purple Heart Award, but I did ring the bell. But listen, after a couple weeks of radiation, I started dreading going for the daily treatment. During chemo, I was able to spend more time at church praying and worshiping. It was great. During radiation, I was wiped out. It was exciting when I got the initial scan after chemo. It showed the cancer was almost gone, just little specks left. So on November 11th, this past Wednesday, had the full PET scan. It's done 3 months after the last treatment. The report says, I took it off the report. The report's right here. And it says, lymphoma cancer is thought unlikely. Amen?
Amen.
So praise God. Means I'm healed. And Melissa, we were both... Listen, we believe God had healed, but it was good to see the report. Amen. Is that right, Melissa? It was good to see the report. And sure, I believed I was healed, but it was Victory in Jesus, help, victory, high bouncing back. I'm going to share a couple scriptures to remember. Isaiah 43, 18 and 19. Forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. Proverbs 21, 31. The horse is made ready for the day of battle, but victory rests with the Lord. Is that not right? Amen? We could strive and thrive and do our best, but victory rests with the Lord. Proverbs 24, 16. For though the righteous fall seven times, they rise again. But the wicked stumble when calamity strikes. I thought about what God has shown me over the last year and the last bit of time. One, remove toxins or poison. Listen, they didn't just try to get part of the cancer out. We had to get it all out, right? And I thought about that. That's physical. That's for my body. But almost think about that for our own spirit, for our own lives. I only have 24 hours in a day. I only have so much time and so forth. That's for all of us. We can't allow poison in our lives. We have to be careful of our ears and hearing and the people we hang with and what we're allowing to go in our minds and our hearts and our ears is not allowing poison. As a matter of fact, is to guard our lives. See, God wants us to bear much fruit, but the only harvest we will have is from the seeds we are planting. We do not want to poison our harvest. Amen. Is that not true?
Amen.
Remove toxins, poison. Secondly, be glad, not sad. See, my father-in-law, Hank, would tell his wife, Marilyn, have fun today. He'd tell her almost every day. Reminder each morning, have fun today.
Exactly.
And listen. Listen, we could want everything to go perfect. And my thought of what's perfect day, and Melissa's thoughts, and Trey's, and everyone, put your name there. Each one of our thoughts on what a perfect day would probably be a little bit different. And probably if we did certain things, it would be similar. But let's face it, every day has its challenges. And every day, there's someone might cut us off in traffic, the food won't be just right. Things won't go perfect. But be glad, be sad, or not sad. Be glad and not sad. See, a week or so ago, 2 weeks ago, I was stressing about something. I was frustrated. I was getting a little bit edgy. Melissa stopped me. I was like, wow, Melissa stopped me. She said, no, be glad, not sad. And I'm like, all right. See, life can be stressful or overwhelming, yet I believe God would speak to us to enjoy life. To look forward to each day, to be glad. And when we're going to have a few more testimonies after I finish sharing here. But listen, when we begin to worship the last few songs, man, let's do a declaration.
Hallelujah.
Let's declare it for today and this week for our lives. Listen, God's in control. And listen, we can have victory. And it starts in the heart. Listen, it starts in the mind to be glad and not sad and to enjoy each moment. Listen, I couldn't believe when I came in, the third thing, see the small victories. Listen, Caitlin, for a half hour before people got here Wednesday, was stapling candy canes in the tracks. She was decorating the tree. She got excited when we put the little tree in the children's room.
Hallelujah.
See, it's easy to get caught up in the big victories. You know, a miracle. We get caught up in the Super Bowl win or whatever, just off the charts, whatever it may be, promotion or whatever. The miracles. God has opened my eyes, to see the small victories in the journey of life.
Yes, hallelujah.
This might sound crazy, but Friday night, just to sit down and, we're going to eat some food later, but to taste those delicious hamburgers and the other food. For about 6 weeks, I had no taste buds.
Oh, hallelujah.
Now, that's tough to swallow food and you can't taste it at all. And you're just doing it just to live. Seeing my son Caleb smile, that's a victory.
It's awesome.
A miracle. See, we were told we couldn't have children. And God has blessed us. eating dinner with my family, seeing my daughter dance and want Bible stories. There's many small victories with work, ministry, home, and life that we all can see. Is that not true? Amen?
Amen.
God would encourage us to see the small victories. Listen, I understand that I do not know what life holds in the days to come. My desire is to be a success in every area and be a more successful pastor, friend, husband, and daddy. And it starts with making the most of every day. I'm thankful and high bouncing back. Amen?
Amen.
How many would say that's me too? That's all of us. Amen. And so I'm going to pray here and just open up, I believe, a couple's already said they're going to share. Lord God, we just thank you, Lord, that I thank you, Lord, for healing my body. I thank you, Lord God, that you've given me new and fresh perspective. And I pray for all of us that we would be glad and not sad. That Lord God, that we would take every day as a gift from you. That we would see the small victories, even this day. That, Lord God, that we wouldn't just be holding out for the big events or the big things in life, but also look at every day and cherish every moment. And Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, I'm going to ask, we put a few minutes here for some other testimonies, and let's see, Dave, I think you said you shared for just a moment. He'll come up the front.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hey, man, well, good to be here. Enjoyed my time here, New Destiny.
Hallelujah.
Ever since I met Pastor Mike down there at WCGC, and yeah, I got the phone call was a couple months back, and they asked me to come in and help run the audio board. I'm like, no problem, be happy to do it. And I'll be able to come to, you know, God's house and hear the word and make some great new friends. And whenever, you know, it's lunch day, doesn't look like it, but I do eat. I'm just joyful. I look forward to every Sunday when I get to come here and just fellowship and hear the word. And I'm also thankful for the education that I'm receiving and the roof over my head. And also, I'm always in thought for those that aren't as fortunate, you know, don't have a roof over their head, or they're out there in the cold, or when it's summertime, the intense heat that happens down here a lot. Of course, we all know that. I'm thankful I can give back and help out when I can.
Amen. 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 John, you come on up. You're going to share for a moment?
Yeah. Blessing to us, too.
Oh, thank you.
I'm so glad to be here.
We're glad to have you.
Tears, and Pastor talked about tears, and ever since I've been coming here, you know, there's joyful tears and there's tears of when you're hurting, but and there's tears of emotion when God really touches you, and the presence of God is here, and I just have to celebrate, I just have to rejoice, because there's so many different little things that happen in the service that bring me to tears. And Jesus said, ask, seek, and knock. And I was stuck in the asking. That's back in Jersey, I was just stuck there. And I found out, you know, that when you're seeking, you're actually going after what God has already said yes to. Because when you ask him, you believe that he has given you what you asked for. And then I learned here that you gotta get up, you gotta bounce back, you gotta seek after what he already said yes to. Right. And before I came here in New Jersey, there was a man of God, and it was right before I left, and a very prophetic man of God, and he had a word, and he said, you know, he said, you've been looking for spiritual experiences with God for a long time, and you've had some failures. You know, it hasn't been what you thought it was gonna be. He said, but coming, he says, you have to get low. he was talking about Mary being at the tomb. He says, you have to get low to see into the darkness, to see the mystery, to see God. And he said that God has all of that for you. So I'm thinking about the ask, the seek, and the knock. And I said, what am I asking for? Just recently, Pastor asked me to speak, and just before that, I was thinking, what am I asking for? I'm asking for my walk with God to be very, very special. And like I said, I was stuck in asking. So now the seeking has, I realized that it's the journey has started for seeking now. But God has been granting the seeking part before I even got to the seeking part. And that's my testimony, because he's revealing himself. I mean, little Caitlin danced, and Kathy ran in to show me the video, and I got touched. And I got a very big surprise, because when I came in here, walked in here, yes, I was filled with emotion, but the whole place was filled with the presence of God, and that's the seeking part. So filled with the presence of God. I'm sitting over there crying. It was just wonderful. Joyful tears, tears of emotion, tears of change. And then we knock, 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 knock until that door comes down, because God said, ask, seek, and knock. And when we asked, we believed. So thank all of you for adding it to my life. Thank you, Pastor.
Amen. Amen. Open it up. Anyone else would like to share for a moment? One? All right.
So lately, I'm not going to stand up, but it's really amazing working where I work. I think there is something very special to be people in, I don't know, in this area, in this county, it's like salt of the earth, you know?
Yeah.
You just, I have encountered so many patients at work who just are lovers of the Lord, and they're not ashamed. Like, they will sit there and they will preach and they will share and they will wear it and they will express it. And it's been such a blessing lately, just encountering so many people who have settled in this area. I've met people from other places, from up north and from Florida and from wherever, people who were born and raised here. But they come into my office and they just love the Lord, and it's such a blessing and an encouragement just to know that there are other people who, because sometimes when you become part of this world and you're working and you're busy, you don't always encounter brothers and sisters, you know. It's been just an encouragement this last couple weeks to know that in this community there are lots of believers and people in prayer.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right. Anyone else like to share with us now? Ella?
I don't know if my baby name will be at the 4 o'clock. So, go ahead.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord.
Yes, indeed. Amen.
There's a name for the Lord. It's called Jehovah Jabesh. It means he war with those at wars with us.
Correct.
Wars against those at wars with us. You know, there's people in here that's been hurt. There's people in here that feel like that you've been thrown under the bus at times. There's people here that feel like there's been some injustice done toward you. I was in a situation a little while back before I came here to where I was thrown under the bus. You know, it's sad to say, Christian people at times will try to get close to you to seem to just hurt you.
Right.
Seem to cut you. And, you know, the Lord's really been dealing with me about when you sit down, I'll stand up. When you be quiet, I'll speak. In other words, what he was telling me was, these people that have wronged you, these people that have hurt you, you don't have to walk around with them between your teeth, you know, angry and vexed in your spirit toward them. He said, because that's not good for you.
Hallelujah.
He implied to me, he said, just roll them off on the Lord. Vengeance is mine.
Right.
vengeance is mine. And you think about that. When someone wrongs you, you know, it feels good to the flesh to try to get back.
You're right.
But the Lord impressed upon me, says, I can do a whole lot better job vindicating.
Hallelujah, you. Hallelujah.
And fighting against them than you can within yourself.
Yes,
just
Lord.
The other day, a person, news got back to me. How many knows the Lord will let news get back to you? At times, people that have wronged you, that vengeance has come. Not that we gloat in it, not that we are to rejoice in it, but I pray for that person. I got word the other day that person is, harvest time has come to their life based upon what they've done to me and probably many more before me. See, everything you do is a seed.
Exactly.
Amen. You continue to sow, you sow, and then you sow.
You create your tomorrows by how you treat people today.
There you go.
Yeah, amen.
Great sermon right there.
And the Lord just shared with me, just like He spoke into my heart, He says, vengeance is coming. Vengeance is coming. I reckon the whole point of what I'm trying to tell you, I'm trying to testify to you that God will fight your battle.
Hallelujah.
Always has.
And the good thing about it is He's never lost a battle.
Of all, hallelujah, that's
He's
true.
Never lost a battle. So my encouragement to you is, sit down so you can stand up.
Oh, all right. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Silence so you can speak.
There you go.
He'll take care of you if you let Him. He'll take care of you.
Wow.
All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to start with some music in just a moment, some more worship. And after those songs, we'll come up and we'll pray over the food and everything and have a great time. But I do want to mention that when we start singing, we can go ahead and worship the Lord in our giving. Those that do and would like to, go ahead and bring it up. And someone asked go ahead and start getting up and getting ready to go. Paul, you always have a testimony in your heart, right? Is that true?
Well, I mean, my whole life is a testimony. And I ran into a very famous person, came into my office the other day and saw me at work, and we had an issue that needed to be dealt with. And they had to know a couple of passes anyway. They're around the area, they already invited me to come speak several different times. And I said, well, I just have to check my schedule. She goes, it's just amazing how I can tell by just meeting you, I just felt I had to do this for you. And I just met this person. But there was several books that they had written. And I says, I just feel compelled to, I want you to have this. And it was very, very nice of this person to do that. But every day is a testimony. I said to her, this person said to me, he says, you're engrossed in the ministry. I said, that's exactly correct. When you get me as a professional, you get both. There's not two different poles, I said. It's all encapsulated in one. And many people think I perform these miracles. I says, miracles are being performed, but it's not me that's performing. God just happens to pick me and use me. And even Wednesday night, I got a message from a particular client. That's enough to, you know, I can't even read the whole thing because I get all choked up. But it's not in a testament to me, it's something that, you know, I tell people, I says, I can't do that because God wants me to do this. And I says, He's in control, and there are certain things that there's a part of me that might want to do that, but I never react that way. And there was a woman before, I told Kathy about it the other day, we were out, and I said, this woman that I dated before her, she didn't like that part of me. I says, let me explain something to you. I says, no matter what anybody does to me, I'm not concerned about it. Because there's always someone who's always got me in the palm of his hand, and he's always does all the protection. Amen. And Kathy and I, we've been to hell and back, actually. We can honestly say that. She's been quite a woman in a lot of ways that you had a lot of the worst, but she has a lot of the good. You see, and God has taken us from we feel very close to you guys in a lot of ways, and we've never even told you that. But I know what Melissa had been through, and I wish I got to meet her dad. You know, because his philosophy in life is exactly the way it should be for every Christian. Jesus Christ said, I come to give you life and to give it to you in all its fullness, abundantly. So we should never have a bad day. We should always, you know, have a spring in our step and a smile in our heart. And it's just a miracle to be alive. And, And right now, I look at things, and professionally, if you would have told me where, would have been where I am just a few years ago, I never would have believed in a million years. And believe me, I've worked very hard, and I've achieved incredible heights in the business world. Okay? And that's not me tapping my own horn. It's what it was. But the Lord has poured out such a blessing. I mean, I can't even take it all in. I mean, if he rolls it in anymore, I don't know what we're going to do with it. But it just goes to show you that. But he also said to me, he says, this is your reward for you having to take care of my people. And believe me, I've met a lot of people where I met a 83-year-old man. I had such a dilemma going on with Social Security. And at that time, I said, my gosh, the work that this is going to take. And then God said to me straight out, my tears rolled right down from my face. And he says, Paul, if you don't do it, no one's going to do it. You see, so he talks to me all this time, and people don't understand, why do you go to such measures? And I says, well, that's the foundation of my life. Jesus Christ always wants you to go the extra mile. And when you go the extra mile, he pours out a blessing that just, it's just, let me just read this one little text. This is what happened Wednesday night. And this gentleman has one of the worst cases of diabetes, and I just want to read it. Not a testimony of who I am, but it's just a testimony of how our lives are engrossed in the ministry, and you don't have to be a pastor to do it. That's what I'm getting at. Let me just get this. So this poor guy has been going through a lot. He, in Medicare, if anybody's familiar with Medicare, they have something called the donut hole or the coverage gap. Okay, so at this point, I got involved to help him get some of this insulin because it's $1,500 a pump. Okay? So he sent me this message on Wednesday. He says, my insulin will be at Dr. Hobson's office in a day or two. I can't even go on with this. I can't thank you enough. Having you in my life has been just a blessing, and what a friend you are. You helped me get my diabetic shoot. I mean, it just goes on and on. Okay? And so I'm around that range that the insulin got there. You see? Because he could afford to pay $1,500. But I get those every day. Every day. And I said, look, did anybody ever come back to Jesus? Didn't Jesus say, where are the other nine? Okay? One person did, you see?
It's true.
You see? But we don't do those. We don't do things for praise. We do things for what God wants us to do. And we have to, what I'm getting at, let me make a long story short. We want to please him. We live our lives to please him, not to please people. And I've never been a people pleaser. I'm going to take it or leave it. But I'm out to please him. And by pleasing him, you'll please people.
Amen. Amen. That's true. That's true.
That
was my dad.
Please,
God.
Please, God.
I know that.
When he died, like, we had no idea everything he was involved in. We were like, oh, he made sure this school got enough books. He made this happen. He made that happen. We didn't know. Because whenever he'd come and visit, he just wanted to know about us. He didn't, he didn't ever talk about everything he was involved in. He would just say, how are they getting this?
Exactly. And that's what we're supposed to do. And I restored families together where family members didn't talk. And I did ever so gently. I had one brother didn't want to talk to the other brother. And I said to his mother said, Paul, if there's something you can do. I said, there's something I can do. And the way I interjected it, I made it look like it was his own idea. It's just a blessing. Because life is too short.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
You should take every time you gather in church.
Seeking man's approval. Amen. Doing what God has called you to do.
Hey, maybe turn up the dime. I hope it's fun. We'll get blessings in the whole world. Maybe the neighbor. Amen. I agree with what you just said, Paul. I can try to please everyone in this place, but I'm never going to succeed.
Correct.
Even with the amount that
we have. But when you please God.
Whether I have 10 in here or we have 50 or 100, I can't please everybody. So what it amounts to is we got to each day live to please God, to do the right thing that God wants us to do. And so maybe we want to be nice to people, right? I mean, that you don't want to be, I'm just kidding. But if we just do what God wants, that's going to bear good fruit. Amen? So, here I'll pray. Lord, we just pray right now as we worship you. And Lord, as it goes through this sanctuary, this building, and maybe even through the area, neighborhood, that just the spirit of you would flow through. Lord, I do want to, we all want to succeed in life. We all want to succeed on the job. We want to succeed in ministry. But most of importantly, we want to please you. And Lord, we pray that would be true today, this morning, and this week, and in our lives. I pray your anointing over this time of worship, and we are doing it for people who are worshiping you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Proud to be, you know, associated with people like that. And
and it kind of it humbles me, because I look back at, you know, when I was that age, you didn't want to be around me, you know. It's just nice that God spoke to me through what you people said. And through these songs.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Well, I heard some food being cooked up, warmed up, so we should be about ready. Is that all right, amen?
Amen.
All right. And stomachs were growling. So I'll go ahead and pray. Good time, good celebration, and now we'll have some good food. Lord, we just thank you that, Lord God, that we can say and proclaim we are yours. And Lord God, we just thank you for this time that we've had together and worship and testimony and scripture and the word. And Lord, we just pray that you would continue the work you have begun in all of our lives. That every day on the job, at home, and everywhere we are, that we would shine forth your light in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray you grow us, spiritually and individually and as a church, and help us to reach more people, especially during the holiday season, the reason for the season. And Lord, we pray over the food and our time of eating and fellowship. Bless it in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we also pray for Dave with the studies. And help us in everything this week. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen.